Hi guys, welcome here at Healthcare. Today I'm going to show you how we can create a Gantt chart, automated Gantt chart and S-curve for plan and actual activities. So here we have this this home workspace of the project planner. So actually this is the heart of the project planner. Okay, so bali dito is meron tayo ditong example. So yung example na kukunin ko is dito lang sa reference manual ng project planner. So if we go directly to the table of contents here, so under project management, and so I have some concepts about project management, project scheduling, project planning, the difference between the planning and scheduling, project scheduling procedure, scheduling dependencies, Gantt chart, S-curve, rule ng S-curve in project management, yung growth slippage and progress. So dito din yung design workflows. Ito yung gagamitin natin as an example. So ito yung mga activities, maliit lang na activities na for just demonstration. But project planner, you can add up to 160 activities, plan and actual. So anyway, for the sake of demonstration, so maliit lang na activities yung gagamitin natin. Okay, so ito na. No? So ito din yung mga amount na kailangan natin. So let's just minimize that one. And so pagka-open natin ng application, yung first natin ginagawa is to initialize the program. Na? Okay, so just click this run icon. So pwede rin, mag-start ka na maglagay ng mga data, and then pag okay ka na sa data lahat, then next is i-perform mo yung project management. So in my case, I click this first, no, to initialize the program. Pero pwede siya sa huli. That's okay, no. So anyway, initialize ko muna. Click lang natin 'to. And then malalaman natin na nag-update yung nag-i-initialize na yung working space natin. Okay? So gumagalaw kasi yung GUI natin dito, no? Ayan, tulad yan, no? So ayan, kusang gumagalaw yan, no? Kusang gumagalaw. Okay, so ayan, so let's wait for the program to initialize. Okay, so tapos na. So next natin gagawin is lalagay na tayo ng data. Okay, so lagay natin na yung contract ID natin is say 111. So kahit na yan, ha? So sabihin natin residential lang. Residential building, yung location is Davao City, you know. And then sabihin natin engineer ka lang. And i-civil engineer. Okay. So after that, next nating i-set up is itong working date natin, ha? So under view, go to date reference. Click natin yan. So, ito na yan. No? So, dito tayo maglalagay ng start date natin. Pero yung kinukuha ko kasi dito is hindi by days, no? By week yung kinukuha ko dito. So, bali, yung kukunin ko lang dito is yung month mo actually, no? So, say, mag-start siya by January, no? So, kung mag-i-input ka dito, ito yung format, no? Una natin isusulat is yung date, then after that, yung month and then year, no? For instance, pero yung i-reflect niya dito sa project planner is na-arrange na siya, no? Then month, date, and then year. Pero pag mag-i-input tayo, dapat ganito yung format. So, say, August 10, no? So, ilalagay natin is 10, then January na lang, no? Say, 1. And then, 2018. So, parang ganun. So, nakikita mo dito na automatic mag-re-arrange yan, January 10, 2018. Okay? So, by default, naka-week ako dito, no? Kasi, diba, sa progress billing, naka-weekly man tayo. Weekly yung progress billing, no? But, you have the option kung gusto mo. So, bali, kung by week, merong, yung project planner, you can add up to 121 weeks, no? So, ganun yun, no? So, kung month, so, you can add up to 121 months, no? Kung days, so, hanggang 121 days lang, no? So, meaning, yung basehan lang talaga dito sa project planner, no? The way I program it is, dito sa reference lang, no? So, the rest for this one is, it's for the, ano na siya sa user, no? So, depende na yan kung ano yung condition or ano yung terms ng user dito, no? For reference 1, okay, so, for reference 1, for me, that's January, sabihin natin, so, that's January week 1, no? So, depende na din yan sa'yo kung ano yung week 1 sa'yo, no? So, alam natin na, di ba, yung 1 week is 7 days, no? So, pwede mong sabihin dito na yung week 1 na yan, yan yung January. That's your, bali, ano na yan, no? Sa user na yan, kung ano yung terms na yan for reference 1. Kasi yung concern lang ni project planner is itong reference, no? Diyan niya kukompute yung ilang weeks yung ano mo, di ba? Okay, so I hope klaro yun. No? It's up to the user na talaga. No? So, January, sabihin natin. Ito is January date 1 to 7. No? Parang ganun. Ito naman is January 8 to 14. No? So, meaning, yan yung duration niya. 1 to 7, then 8 to 14. Then, ito naman is for date 15 to 21, no? Parang ganun, no? So, it's sa user na yan, no? Kasi yung concern lang ni, ano, ni project planners ito. Kasi dito niya i-compute in yung duration mo. Kung depende kung week siya, month, or days. Okay, so, I hope lang yan. 15 to tapos na pala yung 15 to 21. Sabihin natin, 22 to 28. Parang ganun, no? So, itong diba, conventional is yung 1 month is approximately 4 weeks, na? So, applicable lang yan. Kung titignan natin yung calendar, applicable lang yan for February, na? Kasi 28 days. Kahit nga sa February, no? Kasi may leap year tayo, 29, eh. Na? So, yung ginagawa ko dito is hanggang 1 to 5, na? Kasi paano naman yung, for example, January 29 to 31, no? Paano naman yung 31 days in a month? 30 days in a month? 29 days in a month? So depende na sa'yo yan, no? So, meaning, itong kumakabered niya yung 1 to 5, no? Na duration doon sa Gantt chart, it means na meron siyang isang buwan, no? Na na-covered up doon sa overall, di ba? So, it's up to you talaga, no? So, pwede rin, example, ganito, August, no? So, lagay natin dito sa August is ito, week 1, no? Sabihin natin ganyan. So, yung August 1 is, it's really up to you, no? Ito yung 1 to 6, no? Bali, from Monday to Saturday, no? Sabihin natin, ito yung August 1 to 6 from Monday to Saturday. It's really up to the user, no? Kung ano yung mga terms and condition niya for reference 36. Okay? So kung may holiday yan, it's really up to the user. Okay? Kung kinaltas niya ba yung holiday, hindi ba kasali yung Sunday, say it's really up to say, no? Example, itong second week, no? So sabihin natin 8 to 12 na lang yan, no? So it's really up to the user. 8 to 12. Monday to Saturday. Lang ganun, no? So condition na niya, sa kanya na yan, no? Sa condition niya na yan. Okay? So I hope klaro yun. So anyway, makikita mo dito na automatic reflected na din to doon sa, babalikan natin yung working space, automatic reflected na din siya dito. That is, project planner 1 is si user pa yung maglalagay dito. Yeah? So ngayon is, in-automate ko na siya. And then makikita mo dito is January 10 din. So tignan natin kung babaguhin natin, kung mag-update pa itong starting date, tsaka yun dito sa working space natin. So kung i-change natin yun, bali ito, sabihin natin August 10, 2022. Ayan, so ibig sabihin, yung additional notes mo dito is babaguhin mo na, no? Kasi August to, eh, no? So anyway, yung concern lang natin dito is, ito, makikita mo, August na din siya, no? Titignan natin yan. Ayan, makikita mo, August na din yan, September, October, and makikita mo dito na August 10. Diba? Nag-update na siya, no? Automatic na. Okay? So, balikan natin ulit yung date reference. So, bali yung additional notes is, ito yung mga remarks ni user, no? Kung ano yung ibig, kung ano yung mga condition niya for reference 1. Kasi reference 1 lang yung basis dito sa, ano? Okay? Sa project planner. So, it's really up to the user kung ano yung mga condition niya for that reference number. So, sabihin natin, balik tayo sa January 10, 2018. Anyway, example lang ito. Okay? So, yun na, no? Pagtapos ka na dito, so let's say, kung wala ka namang additional notes, so, you can leave it blank on din. Bali, okay na sa'yo na ganito, no? Like, reference 1 is January week 1. Reference 2, for me, that is January week 2. Reference 3 for me, that is January week 3. No? But, bali dito sa date reference, yung pwede mo lang i-change dito is itong weeks. No? Itong dito, tsaka yung additional notes. Itong reference number is protected yan. No? Kasi yun yung basihan ng code ko. Eh. Tsaka itong month and week number, automated yan. No? So for instance, na, lalagay natin instead na 5 weeks hanggang 4 lang, no? Sabihin natin 1 2 3 4. And after 4, mag-go 1 ka ulit, no? So tignan mo, kung titignan mo to dito, 5 yan kasi January pa, no? Pero kung maglalagay ka ng 1, automatic mag-February yan dito. So 1 2 3 4. Ayan, so makikita mo, nag-update din siya, no? 1, 2, 3, 4, parang ganun. Ayan, no? Makikita mo, nag-update. So, dito is 1, 2. So, nagbabago din yun. So, once ma-detect ni Project Planner na nag-1 ka ulit, so, nag-update siya sa next month. Yeah. Okay? So, I'll stick with my default na 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, pwede ka mag-change dito, no? By week. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ayan. Okay? So, ayaw ko lang yan. So, dito lang, no? Dito sa week, you can change that one. The user can change that one. And also, the user can add additional notes. Yung reference number tsaka yung month, week, default. Okay. So, balik tayo dito sa working space natin. So, kung okay ka na dun sa working space mo, punta ka naman sa activities. So, dito tayo sa activities. And, so, you can add activities. So, dito sa reference manual, ito lang yung gagamitin natin ng mga activities. Yan lang. Ha? Just a basic example for illustration. So, sabihin natin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So, lagay ko lang yung mga description ng activities. So, I have planning. Planning and planning and design, mobilization, clearing works, staking and layouting, steel reinforcement works. We have formworks, staging and scaffolding. We have concreting works, masonry works, tile works, and other finishing works. And then finish. So yan lang, ha? So kung tapos ka na dyan, pwede ka na bumalik dun sa working space. Ayan, so ito na, no? So since na-initialize na natin yung program, di ba? Na-click natin simula pa lang. So automatic mag-update na yan dito, no? So for example, dito sa item. Ayan. So may drop down yan. List. Akyat lang natin. So pili natin yung item 1. So, click tayo sa next. Makikita mo dito na automatic na din yung description. So, yung nilagay natin sa activity list is ire-reflect na yan dito sa working space. So, sabihin natin activity 2. Ayan, makikita mo automatic mag-re-reflect na siya. Activity 3. Ayan. Or pwede rin, hindi ka na mamili sa drop-down list. No? So, okay lang yung drop-down list kung mahirap yung item number na parang labeling ng mga activities mo. Okay yun, no? Kung mahirap siya. Pero kung hindi man din, di man din siya mahirap, like 1, 2, 3, 4 lang. So, pwede mo na lang i-type yan sa keyboard mo. No? Like 4, enter, 5, enter, di ba? Ganun na lang. No? Kung di naman mahirap yung labeling ng item. Ginamit kasi ito kasi sa DPWH mga item, last nila is may mga AA, mga ganun, no? Diba? So, dun siya maganda, no? Pero pag ganito yung item, diretso na, no? Hindi mo na kailangan ng drop-down list para sa 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So anyway, patuloy ko muna ito. 9 and then 10. Hanggang 10 activities lang naman yun. Okay, so automatic magre-reflect yan. Ayan. So, after that, maglalagay na tayo dito ng unit. Sabihin lang natin, yung unit nito is i-sum up ko na lang lahat, no? Lump sum na kabali. So, sabihin ko lahat na lang. Or lump sum, no? Pwede na din. So, Excel man to, no? So, meaning, pwede mo itong, pwede kang mag-Control-C dito, then, Control-V. Okay? Para copy-paste. Ayan, so, makikita mo dito, no? Okay na tayo dito. Ngayon, yung quantity, kasi lump sum lang yung ilagay ko. Sabihin ko na lang na 1 lahat. No? And then, copy-paste ko na lang to. Control-C. So, may magda-dancing line yan. Indicating na copy mo siya. And then, paste. No? So, dito sa unit cost, ito yung gagamitin ko. Ito sila ng mga amount. Okay? So, lalagay ko lang yan. Dito. So, bali dito, I have $10,000. So, makikita mo automatic magkakama yan, ha? For every 3 digit. Ayan, para di ka mawala. $150,000. $100,000. Ayan, kulang ako ng 0. So, naging kulit ng 0. 100,000. $15,000. 2 million. Then 1.5 million. Then 1 million. Then may example lang to, no? Yung mga unit cost. So 500,000. Wait lang, parang may nakaligtan ako. 10,000. 150,000, 100,000, 15,000, 2 million, 1.5 million, 5 million talaga, 5 million. And then this one is 1 million. So automatic, kukumpute na din ni project planner yung amount tsaka weight na. And then 500,000. And then 12,000. Ayan. Okay, so after natin ma-input lahat, so actually yung amount, pwede mo yung compute-in by clicking this icon, but it takes time, no? Kasi i-re-recompute niya up to 160 activities, no? A total of 320 rows, no? For both plan and actual. Yung weight naman, pwede mong i-recalculate din yan by clicking this icon, or you can go to analysis, then amount or weight calculation, but it takes time kasi magko-compute siya ng 320 cells, no? Kasi meron tayong 160 plan activities and 160 actual activities for the project planner. So, medyo it takes time kasi isa-isahin niya. Anyway, by default, automated na yung amount tsaka weight, no? Sa project planner 1 is hindi automated yan, no? Kaya ngayon, in-automate ko na.